What if I told you you can prepare for meetings, stay on task in meetings, oh, and collaborate in real time before, during, and after meetings without even having to leave Google Calendar? Well, you can with this free Chrome extension. Hey friends, I'm Tasia Custode. Welcome back to my YouTube channel where I share tech tips and app reviews. And today's video is made in partnership with what I think is the best Chrome extension for remote meetings, Shepherd. I've been lucky enough to partner with Shepherd, but y'all know me. I do not take partnerships lightly, and I can say with certainty that I have become slightly obsessed with the Shepherd Chrome extension. And I think by the end of this video, you might be too. So let's go. So first, let's talk about how you're gonna set up Shepherd. You're gonna download Shepherd from the Chrome Web Store for free, and I've got links to both Shepherd's site and the Chrome Web Store link below. So next, you're going to connect your Google account to Shepherd. So what you're gonna do is give access permissions because Shepherd is connected to your Gcal and Google Meet. So once you have that all set up, I think it took me less than 2 minutes, you're gonna tell Shepherd how you will use it. Now this helps tailor Shepherd to your needs and your specific job. Now I did refresh my Gcal after setting this all up, but that's really it. You can begin using Shepherd however you wish. So Shepherd is a Google Calendar and Google Meet plugin, essentially. You can add agendas, take notes, and prepare for meetings all from the right-hand panel in your Gcal or your Google Meet. Now, one of the features that I like is that everything is really integrated nicely. Shepherd is not a separate thing you're gonna have to toggle between. So you can select an event on the calendar, whether it's a meeting or not, and you'll be able to open Shepherd from here and instantly start taking notes. You can also just open Shepherd by clicking directly on the logo on the right-hand side panel if you prefer, but no matter how you get there, this is really great for meeting prep in order to prepare all your notes before you even start a meeting. It can definitely help you stay on track during your meeting, which I'm going to tell you a little bit more about later. But from here, you can also invite others to join Shepherd or invite contacts to collaborate with you, and any team members you have included in this meeting will appear right here for you too. And to be clear, both you and your team members have to be using the Shepherd Chrome extension in order to collaborate like this before and during and after meetings. Now, speaking of meetings, you can also join your meetings directly from this same right-hand side panel. But before we do that, let's get a little more familiar with this Shepherd panel. So you and your team can collaborate in real time under this shared notes section. Here you're gonna be able to at mention team members, and you can also assign tasks to team members. And pro tip, if you select the /key, you'll have a quick options list where you can at mention someone, add a task, add a table, a bullet list, number list, checkbox, links, quotes, images, GIFs, and so on. I absolutely love the bulleted task list or checkbox so you and team members can check off their tasks as they complete them. Now you can also head over to the My Notes section to take your own notes that are just for you. They aren't shared with the rest of the team. So this is great if it's a note that doesn't really pertain to anyone on the team, but it's something you need to remember to follow up on in the project or meeting. And again, these are just for you only. So the only other way someone else would see this notes section is if you were sharing your screen and you had the My Notes tab open. Then there's a Tasks tab, which is pretty self-explanatory. You can add and organize tasks for the entire team here. So this is a great little progress report section where you can organize the tasks based on status. And then there's this private note section where you can message privately with just specific meeting attendees and not the entire group. So what you can do is invite the ones you want in the private chat, and then that person's gonna get a notification to join the private chat that pertains to this meeting, and you can message privately with each other. There's a previous button on the bottom here, which I'm gonna touch on a little bit later because It's actually really, really helpful during a meeting as well. So for now, let's head to the quick add task option at the bottom. This is where you can add a task and a description to the task. You can assign a task from here and even add a due date for the task as well. And then there's also a quick add template option at the bottom. So if you find yourself using the same or similar meeting agendas over and over again, you can quickly save that as a template to use again rather than starting from scratch each time. But wait, there's more. Shepherd also comes with pre-made templates for you. So if you click on templates and then select browse, you're gonna have a list of Shepherd templates. Simply select insert to use a template. And then of course you can customize this template however you want. But let's say you're making this super organized meeting agenda prior to your meeting and you want to share it out with someone outside of your organization who's on your meeting invite but doesn't have Shepherd. Well, guess what? You can do that too. I know. So all you have to do is click on share and you're going to get a glimpse here of all the share options, which I'm going to go over a little bit later. But for now, let's choose add to Google Calendar event. Select shared notes and click on add. So now this meeting agenda that you've created, all these notes in this shared notes section have been shared directly to the Google Calendar event. So here we are in the GCal event and voila, the shared notes are populated right here directly in the GCal event for all the attendees to see. But if you want to get out of that particular meeting and get a broad overview of all your notes and tasks, you can do that too. So at the top, you can switch to the All Notes section to get your dashboard of notes. So these are going to be all your notes from about a week back up until today's date. And remember, you can always access your notes from GCal at any time. So theoretically, you could go back like 6 months if you wanted to and open your notes from an old calendar event, just as an example. Now you can also switch to the All Tasks tab to get a quick overview of all the action items in one spot. So this is actually quite a well laid out, comprehensive, because you get a snapshot of what's to do, what's already in progress, and then what tasks have been completed. And if you have a ton of tasks, you can very simply figure out which tasks belong to what project. All you have to do is select the three-dot menu icon to the right of the task, and select go to meeting, and you're going to be popped over to that meeting where you can get some more context as to what that project or meeting was about and how your task fits in there. So now let's take a look at what Shepherd actually looks like in action during a meeting. So as I mentioned, you can join a Google Meet from your calendar event or right here from the Shepherd panel if you want. Either way, once you're in a meeting, you're gonna have the same Shepherd panel toggle on the right. If you open that up by clicking on it, out pops the all familiar right side panel, and it looks the same as it does in your GCal, but now you're in your Meet. And when you've got that panel open, your view is adjusted for you, so it doesn't sit on top of any attendees' faces or anything. It's nice and clean to the right. So here you can collaborate just as you did before the meeting. So remember earlier we talked about using the /key as a shortcut? Well, I'll use that again here to bring up another favorite feature of mine, timestamps. So this is really helpful if you're taking meeting minutes and you have to notate something specific at a certain time in the meeting. Now you can easily reference back to that. Now, still in this current meeting tab, you can check out previous notes from previous meetings. So say you have a recurring weekly team meeting, this is going to allow you to review all the previous meeting notes without having to leave your Google Meet. This is really great if you want to make sure you accomplished those set goals that you had prior to this meeting, or if you want to ensure you're staying on track for this meeting. I swear to you, Shepherd makes collaborating with a team and staying on task so freaking easy. Like, where have you been my whole life? Anyway, Once your meeting is complete, you can click on share. So for example, if you work in Gmail, Trello, Notion, Asana, it's really set up for you to use as you see best fit. So if you want to send out this meeting summary via email, for example, you can do that. Or if you already use Trello, Shepherd syncs up with Trello automatically, so you're not having to duplicate your tasks over there. Go forth and share however your little heart desires. Now, as I was making this video, the team at Shepherd was a bunch of busy bees putting the final touches on a couple new features that somehow make Shepherd even better. First up, you can now view Shepherd in full screen. So if you want to make your side panel bigger, just click on the Open Shepherd in Full Screen option, and a new tab will open up for you that has your notes dashboard, your tasks, and of course, the current meeting notes in full screen for you. So this is really great if you're on an audio call and you want to quickly just take some notes. You can pop on over to full screen and not worry about not making eye contact with people in the meeting. And then second, there are now desktop notifications that will notify you of upcoming meetings and include the meeting links for you. So you never have to worry about missing a meeting. And you can just toggle on the desktop notifications from your settings in Shepherd. So all of this is great and all, and Shepherd is probably the most comprehensive Google Chrome extension I've ever used. And trust me, I've used a lot. But you wanna know what makes it even better? Shepherd is completely free to download. Yeah, my favorite thing, free. But seriously, how cool is this extension? Let me know in the comments below. So that's my comprehensive review of what I think is the best free Chrome extension for remote meetings. And now I want to hear from you. What do you think of Shepherd? Have you used it? Will you use it? What are your favorite features? Let everyone know in the comments below. As always, thank you so much for watching. If you like this video, well, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel, and here for even more Chrome content. Thanks so much for watching. See you next time.